Random House Audio presents Diet Myths That Keep Us Fat and the Truths That Will Save Your Waistline and Maybe Even Your Life by Dr. Nancy Snyderman. This is the author, Dr. Nancy Snyderman. Very few of us are ever entirely happy with our weight, and I hate the feeling of putting on a few extra pounds. But I found some healthy and acceptable ways to get down to a healthy weight, things that really work. If you're like I once was, tired of going on and off diets and up and down in weight, I'm going to help you get and stay naturally fit while eating anything you want, not depriving yourself, and appreciating the wonderful body you have. How can I make such claims? Well, I'm a veteran of the diet wars, a doctor, and a reporter. Between medical school, my internship, and my residency, getting pregnant for the first time in my 30s, and the second time in my 40s, and doing live television, I've done it all. I've starved myself, and I've pigged out. I've binged, dieted, skipped meals, and lived to tell about it. I subsisted on vanilla wafers and black coffee while serving my residency in pediatrics. I relied on graham crackers and peanut butter during my surgical training. I've been on liquid diets and protein diets, one week this diet, the next week that diet. I've exercised in sauna suits and I've dieted on carrot sticks. There are times when I spent so much time poking my head in the fridge that my nose got frostbite. Add whatever you've done to this list and I would understand. But finally, when diet became a four-letter word to me, I said, enough is enough. I started making friends with food. So now I have an easy rule. I regard food as fuel. I eat foods I like, even some things that might not be so good for me. As a result, I find it easier to lose weight. I just eat a bit less and exercise a bit more, and it falls off. I'm not a member of a health club. It's just not my thing. I prefer walking, hiking, or biking outdoors to keep fit. I watch my weight, but I'm not obsessive about it, and I wouldn't deny myself something I really wanted. Every week, I try to enjoy something from each of my four favorite food groups: the chocolate group, the ice cream group, the pizza group, and yes, the chips group. But most of the time, I choose healthy foods. Do I have a perfect body? No, not really, but I know I'm healthy. Making friends with food, with diets, and with your body isn't easy. And a big reason is that most of us have been following certain rules for losing weight all our lives. These rules come and go. We are fascinated by them. We follow them. We throw out everything we're doing and embrace the latest rule. If it doesn't work, we blame ourselves for messing up. The truth is that these rules are largely myths, misinformation that is often considered to be true. Nutrition is a fairly new science, and it's pretty boring stuff unless you're a dietitian. But the most important thing we all need to remember about it is it's always changing. That constant change generates loads of myths, many of which I'll explore in this book. Myths like calories don't count, carbs are bad, and you can't keep pounds off. We get fat over the course of years, but we want it off by next Thursday. Hardly a week goes by without some expert somewhere issuing a new report declaring that a certain pill or a certain diet or surgery is the latest magic bullet for weight loss. After being a doctor for more than 30 years, having reported on thousands of diet and nutrition stories, and being a professional dieter myself, I can tell you this: no magic bullet exists. What we need is a new and smart strategy for successful weight loss. Statistics show that 45 million Americans are dieting at any moment in time, and we're spending more than $30 billion a year on weight loss. Yet, obesity is rarely treated successfully. We have a serious problem. We are the only animals on the planet that will eat ourselves into an early grave. 2 centuries ago, people died of starvation. That trend is changing. Ours will be the first generation to die from food excess. It's insane. Since the early 1980s, Americans increasingly have grown larger. We are 10 pounds heavier, on average, than we were just 15 years ago. And we eat 15% more calories today than in 1984. We're at a tipping point in this country where obesity has started to cost us our longevity. Proper weight is not just a matter of looking good. It is about health. Being healthy is knowing you can count on your body. Being healthy is about enjoying a well-rounded life, pursuing physical activities you love, enjoying a balanced diet that makes room for all foods in moderation, and tuning into your emotional and spiritual health. One answer to our national paunch is to stop obsessing about what we eat and start sorting out the sound advice from the babble. In spite of all the conflicting information, the tried and true still holds. Load up on real foods like fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. Practice portion control and exercise regularly. It couldn't be simpler. And because it's so simple, people find it really boring. But these actions are the only safe and stable ways to lose weight. I feel that beyond being a mythbuster, this audiobook should also act as a pal. I can help you most effectively if I give you enough truthful information to guide you out of the confusing diet maze. You can't get in shape and stay healthy unless you know the truth. This audiobook will bring you face to face with the truth about dieting and weight loss. And armed with that truth, you'll learn how to check out information before you act on it. For example, if you were told that eating 15 grapefruits each day would help you burn fat, would you go to the nearest supermarket and stock up, or would you check it out first? Make informed decisions using sound, straightforward information. Question whether a popular diet will really work for you. Learn to make a friend of food and exercise. This will allow you to safely sprinkle the not-so-healthy stuff throughout your diet and not feel deprived. Understand that being overweight isn't always the result of overeating and under-exercising. There's a lot more to fatness than lack of willpower. For many of you, being overweight is not your fault, yet there are still many factors that are within your power to change. How you eat can lower your risk of heart disease, stroke, and certain cancers. Discover little-known yet powerful facts and motivating ideas that can keep you trim and energetic. Make important, permanent changes, the kind you can live with for the rest of your life in your eating habits. Escape the forbidden food mentality. Allow yourself some leeway and learn to enjoy food again with My Treat, and lose weight in the process. Whether your weight loss goal is 5 pounds, 50 pounds, or more, you can achieve it in some of the most enjoyable ways possible by eating the foods you love in satisfying moderation. It's not about becoming supermodel thin or adhering to someone else's ideal. It's about being healthy and feeling great. And it's never too late to begin the journey. I am living proof that decades-old diet patterns can, with intervention and commitment, be changed. I am at peace with food, and I want you to be at peace too. An investigation of 10 of the most common diet myths follows. At the conclusion of each discussion about myths, I'll give you a number of medical truths and extra information, tips, advice, and the latest particulars on how to lose those pounds, keep them off, and enhance your health and enrich your life. Then, after we debunk the diet myths that keep us fat, I'll introduce you to my...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.